So let's start with the next topic, which is roles and responsibilities of an investigator in a clinical trial. Please enter your name in the chat box to mark your attendance. That is very important. And then we shall start with the topic. So as you can see, next is next on this slide would be, just a yes, Ketan, you have something to say? You can ask me if you have something. Okay. Maybe I'll have to download this slide. Just a minute, okay? Just give me 1 minute over here. Hello. Really sorry for the inconvenience. Yeah. So we'll start with the roles and responsibility of the sponsor, not the investigator. Okay? According to ICH-GCP, what are the roles and responsibility of a sponsor in a clinical trial? That is what we are going to learn. Okay? So GCP is an international ethical and scientific quality standard for designing, conducting, recording, and reporting trials that involve in the participation of human subjects. So the guideline was developed with consideration of current good practices of EU, Japan, and the US, as well as those of Australia, Canada, and the Nordic countries, and the WHO. So all these countries contributed in making of this guideline, ICH-GCP guidelines, okay? So one of the part of this ICH-GCP guideline is the roles and responsibility of a sponsor, okay? So who is a sponsor? So sponsor is an individual or company, institution, or organization that takes responsibility for the initiation, management, or financing of a clinical trial. I have made this definition very clear when we were talking about it. Then the sponsor includes commercial, that is pharmaceutical and devices, commercial companies. It could be either a pharmaceutical company or a device, medical device company. It could be a governmental funding agency. It could be a private foundation or an individual who is willing to sponsor to the further study. So next thing is sponsor's team consists of whom all? So sponsor's team consists of project manager, CRA, that is clinical research associate, या फिर monitor. Then it has a clinical research organization. Then data manager, biostatistician, and medical writer. So all these members can be on the team of the sponsor. Then QA/QC. Just a minute, okay. So in quality control and quality assurance, from sponsor's point of view, what is their role? Okay, to ensure the trials are conducted, data are generated, documented, and reported in compliance with the protocol, GCP, and regulatory requirements concerned. To ensure the direct access to all trial-related sites, source data documents, and reports for all involved in parties who secure the agreement for purpose of monitoring, inspecting, and auditing. So there should be direct access to all these people we just named right now. Okay, there should be a direct access to all the source data for all the people who are involved in monitoring, inspecting, and auditing of a trial. Then what is the role of QA/QC, which could be also one of the members, which are definitely members of sponsor team? That is what is mentioned over here. So that is what we are talking about. To ensure that all data are reliable and have been processed correctly, and then to ensure that all agreements in writing with the parties involved in the trial. So all these things have to be taken care by the QA/QC. So what is CRO? CRO is a sponsor may transfer any or all the sponsor's trial related duties and functions to a CRO. But the ultimate responsibility for the quality and integrity of a trial data always reside with the sponsorer. The CRO should implement QA/QC's responsibility. So as I was telling you, Glenmark has a facility of conducting a BAB trial, but they do not entertain any other trials rather than Glenmark. But if you talk about Quintiles, IQVIA is the company where most of our your seniors are working. They are the company who take the clinical trials or fir BAB trial studies from all other organization. Means Glenmark can give them make them a CRO, and all their studies can be done over there. Cipla can do the studies over there. So they are what, clinical research organization, okay, individual clinical research organization. So they don't work for any specific company. They can work for any company whomsoever approaches to them for conducting their clinical trial or fir BAB trial, okay. So CRO can either be associated with the sponsor, or CRO can be individual, can be his individual property. Like in the sense, if the sponsor is Glenmark, then Glenmark have their own facility to conduct the clinical trial or fir BAB trials. Okay, so CRO is very important. The sponsor medical expertise. The sponsor should designate appropriately qualified medical personnel who will be readily available to advise on trial related medical questions or problems. If necessary, outside consultants may be appointed for this purpose. So medical expertise, let me tell you this thing, one MBBS in general medicine person has to be there in the facility 24/7. The full-time recruitment of a medical physician has to be there in a CRO, okay? Then trial design. What is the role of a sponsor in trial design? That is what they are telling. The sponsor should utilize qualified individuals, for example, qualified biostatistician, clinical pharmacologist, and physician as appropriate throughout all stages of trial process, from designing the protocol and CRF and planning the analysis to analyzing and preparing interim and final clinical trial report. So it's a very important job of a sponsor to recruit all these people, or fir assign the proper task to all these people, so that you have all the documentation ready and you have a proper protocol and case report forms of each and every individual ready. Okay. Then the scientific integrity of the trial and the credibility of the data from the trial depends on the substantiality on the trial design. What is the credibility and what is the integrity of the trial will depend on what kind of a trial design you have in order to conduct that particular clinical trial, or fir study treatment ka jo koi bhi trial tumhe karna hai wo. So a description of the trial design should include primary and secondary endpoints. We have seen what do you mean by primary and secondary endpoints. Then description and of the type and the design of the trial to be conducted. You also know now by, you must know by now what do you mean by type and the design of the trial, and its major trial treatments and the dosage regime, stopping rules or discontinuation criteria for individual subjects and accountability, etc. See, dosage is different and dosage regime is different. So dosage might include what would be the route of administration and what could be the dosage in the sense dosage regime in the sense how many times to be taken in a day or something like that. Okay. So all these responsibilities also lie within the sponsor. Okay, as I have been always telling you, protocol designing mein investigator, sponsor, biostatistician, all these people, clinical pharmacologist and physician, they have a very big role to play. Okay, in order to design a protocol, make sure that protocol is to the mark and all the points are included what we discussed in last 3 to 4 sessions. Then in trial management, data handling and record keeping, what is the role and responsibility of the data manager. So the sponsorer, what is the role of the sponsorer? The sponsorer should consider in establishing an IDMC by utilizing qualified individual to assess the progress of a clinical trial. IDMC is nothing but a monitoring team which will always keep a track of the progress of a clinical trial from sponsor's point, from sponsor's side. Okay, so investigator will might also the sponsor would always have somebody to take care of all the aspects which are required for regular maintenance of the data and also make sure that all the progress of the clinical trial is going according to the protocol. Then when using electronic trial data handling or remote electronic data system, the sponsor should. So this particular statement they are making, it is a part of the clinical data management. Okay, remote electronic trial data system in the sense manually then they enter the data. Electronic trial data handling in the sense they enter the data and then accordingly somebody else will validate it or something like that. So both of them do the same kind of a task. This particular thing you guys are going to learn in your fourth semester. Then maintain the SOPs for using this system. So for electronically handling the data, you have to make sure that they are following the SOP rules. Then ensure that the systems are designed to permit data changes. Maintain a security system that prevents unauthorized access, safeguard the blinding, if any. Okay? So, see, when you are entering the data electronically, there are high chances that the data could be leaked, when especially we are doing the blinded studies. Okay? So, all these SOPs has to be followed in a proper manner to make sure that the blinding has been prevented. Means like the blinding is still on and none of the data has been leaked and seen by people who are not supposed to see them. This I have explained in a very simple terminology for you. So any transfer of ownership of the data should be reported to the appropriate authorities. Okay? In the sense, a sponsor and investigator will always have the data with them. Okay? But if you want to transfer the data ownership to somebody else, then it should be documented accordingly and reported accordingly. The sponsor's specific essential documents should be retained until at least 2 years after the last approval of the marketing application. That means after phase four, they should retain the data at least for 2 years. The sponsor should inform the investigator institution in writing of the need of the record retention and should notify accordingly. So after 2 years, also, if they want to retain the data, then why do they want to do that? That is what they have to justify and notify accordingly. Then these are the responsibilities of the sponsor when it comes to trial management, data handling, and record keeping. Okay? Then investigator selection. The sponsor is responsible for selecting the investigator. The sponsor should provide the investigator with the protocol and up-to-date investigator's brochure. So this is when they are talking about that a sponsor in himself has a investigator. In the sense, Glenmark has their own principal investigator. Okay? So there could be more than one principal investigator. So he will be choosing the principal investigator amongst lot many options he has. Okay, and he should be the one who would provide the investigator with all the protocol and up-to-date information about the investigator's brochure. So we know by far what is investigator's brochure. The sponsor should obtain the investigator's agreement first to conduct the clinical trial in compliance with GCP. Then, see, when we are talking about the investigator selection, he can select a person from outside or he can use a person who is available in his facility. Okay? So this is when a sponsor is a company ya fir institution. Okay? Jinko ek investigator ki zarurat hai, who would work with under sponsorer and take care of the clinical trial. So he should make sure that the investigators, he's making an agreement with the investigator stating that he will conduct the trial in compliance with GCP, then to comply with the procedure for data recording, to permit the monitoring and auditing and inspection, to retain the trial related essential document until the sponsor informs the investigator these documents are no longer needed. ठीक है, जब तक उसकी जरूरत है तब तक उसको retain करने का काम investigator का रहेगा. Then the sponsor and investigator or the institution should sign the protocol or an alternative document to confirm this agreement. So this has to be documented and signed by investigator, sponsor or the company. Okay. Then allocation of the responsibility. Prior to initiating a trial, the sponsor should define, establish and allocate all trial related duties and functions. Okay, so कौन क्या करेगा, प्रिंसिपल इन्वेस्टिगेटर क्या करेगा, वो उसने अभी यहाँ पे लिखा. देन आफ्टर इन्वेस्टिगेटर हु कम्स, सीआरओ कम्स, देन क्लिनिकल रिसर्च एसोसिएट कम्स, देन क्वालिटी अश्योरेंस क्वालिटी कंट्रोल कम्स, व्हाट ऑल दे विल बी डूइंग, दैट इज व्हाट ही द स्पॉन्सरर विल हैव टू डिसाइड एंड एस्टैब्लिश द प्रोटोकॉल अकॉर्डिंगली. ठीक है, then next is compensation to subjects and investigator. So the sponsor should provide insurance or should indemnify the investigator against claims arising from the trial, except for the claims that arises from the malpractice or from the negligence. So he will be basically taking responsibility for all the subjects and investigator, unless and until there is a malpractice happening or fair negligence is happening. The sponsor's policies and procedures should address the cost of the treatment of the trial subject in the event of trial related injuries and in accordance with the applicable regulatory requirements. So during the clinical trial or until the subjects are there in their facility, if something happens, the whole and sole responsibility of the treatment will remain with the sponsor. Okay, and when trial subject receive compensation, the method and manner of compensation should comply with applicable regulatory requirements. So what do you mean by compensation? Generally, it is a monetary compensation which is given to all the subjects who are participating into the clinical trial. And this compensation, how they will be given, whether it will be in the cash or it will be a bank transfer, all that also has to be mentioned. Why it is only with the sponsor, why investigator cannot do it? Because what kind of compensation will be, how much of the compensation will be, and how the compensation will be given, it is all sponsor's responsibility, because he is the one who is putting money for the clinical trial. Chicken. So that is what is very important. So we have 2 minutes left with us. If there are any questions, we can take it right now. Otherwise, we can take them in next session. That would be tomorrow. Okay. So anybody has any question, you can ask me right now. I'm very sorry for starting the lecture so late. My system is giving a little bit of a problem. So it was updating basically, so I couldn't log in early. Are there any questions? Tanuja? Are you there, Tanuja?
Yes, ma'am.
Are there any questions by far?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Then we should go ahead and you can mute yourself. There is a lot of background noise at your place. Yeah. So if there are any questions, you can always put on the Google Classroom, may be related to our teaching, may be related to any other issue, or even with the Kalyani ma'am, whatever, if you want to ask anything to Kalyani ma'am, you can go ahead and ask in the live stream of Google Classroom. Means in the sense, it's like a chatting box over there. So you can ask over there, or you can individually WhatsApp us or ask on our group. Okay, so I'll be posting these slides on the Google Classroom material, and you guys can access it. And I will be telling you guys if we are doing a quiz 2 days prior to the quiz. Okay, so that you guys have enough time to study. So I'm signing off for now. I shall see you guys tomorrow. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.